Hey everybody, and welcome back to another episode of 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts in less than 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. In this episode, I'll go over shortcuts. If you watch this series, you know I'm a huge fan of saving as much time as possible so I can focus on creating. We will take a look at a handful of shortcuts, and you'll be on your way to saving a ton of time. I'll be uploading a text document with these shortcuts so you can have them at your side until you memorize them. Okay, so this first shortcut is Control-N, and this creates a new composition. It's the same thing as going up to Composition, New Composition. So Control-N starts your new composition. Okay, so once you have that composition, say you need to change the settings of it. The way to do that is Control-K, and that brings up this composition settings box right here. So Control-K brings up your composition settings. Instead of hitting Control-K, you may go to Composition, Composition Settings. As you can see right here, it has your shortcut listed. So now once you're in a composition, you may want to create a solid. Now you can always go up to Layer, New, Solid, or simply hit Control-Y. Okay, so another good shortcut, say you have your solid in here, but you need to pre-comp it, or say you have several solids, and you want to pre-comp some of these or even all of these. The way you do that is Control-Shift-C. The other way of doing this would be to go to Layer, Pre-compose. Okay, a very common shortcut is Control-D, and what that does is it duplicates. Now, you can use Control-D to duplicate anything. So say you have this solid right here and you want to duplicate that. Control-D, however many times, makes multiple layers. You can also duplicate comps. So with that highlighted, Control-D. Say in this black solid, we want to add a fill. So effects, generate, fill. Say for some reason, if you wanted to duplicate the fill, highlight fill, Control-D. So Control-D will duplicate any element within After Effects. Okay, so now we have these four comps here. So now it depends on which comp that you're in. But say if you're in, say, comp 4, if you hit Control-W, it closes out that comp. And this could be useful, say, if you have a whole string of comps lined up all the way across the top of your timeline here. So say you have all four of these and you just want to get rid of one. Just make sure it's the one that you have highlighted. Say you have 8 comps lined up and you just want to get rid of all of them for now so that way you can start over with a clean page. If you hit Control-Alt-W, that will close out all of your comps. Okay, so now another cool shortcut involves the brackets. But say you want this whole layer to be way down here. Now you can either grab it and kind of, you know, drag it like that and hope you get to the right spot, or if you know it needs to be at the 4-second mark, you can hit the left bracket and it pulls the whole layer over. So anywhere you go, hit the left bracket and it drags it around. Okay, so now say you want to move the layer down, but you don't want to include these keyframes. Say, for example, you changed your mind about animating it in. Now, you could just get rid of the keyframes, or if you come anywhere on your timeline and hit Alt left bracket, it pulls your layer over to wherever your playhead is. This is useful in more complicated animations, but just so you know, a way to pull this around is Alt left bracket, and the way to move the entire layer over, including the keyframes, is just the left bracket itself. So say you want to move this back to the beginning, just hit left bracket. Now say you wanted your layer to end right here, you can also hit Alt right bracket, and that won't affect your keyframes at all. Now if you just use the right bracket by itself, it will move your layer all the way left like that. So it will affect your keyframes. So just hit the right bracket and see your keyframes have disappeared. So the left and right brackets move the entire layer, whereas Alt right bracket would just end your layer there, just as Alt left bracket would begin it wherever your playhead is. Another shortcut, and I've used this quite a bit in my other tutorials, is the keyframe interpolation shortcut. So say you want this keyframe right here to be easy in. You can always right click keyframe assistant easy in, or you can just shift F9. Now, if you just want your keyframes to be Bezier keyframes, select one or both and hit F9. If you need an easy out, control shift F9. Easy in, shift F9. So I'll do that again. So F9 makes them Bezier. Shift F9 makes it easy in. Control Shift F9 makes it easy out. Okay, so say you have these Bezier keyframes, but you want them to be linear instead. Well, if you control click, it turns that into a linear keyframe. So again, with Easy Ease keyframes, if you right click on either one of these and get keyframe assistant, you get the Easy Ease, Easy In, and Easy Out. Turning this back into a linear keyframe is not one of the options. You have to go up here to keyframe interpolation. You could turn both of these into linear, and then you'll have it back. But the fastest way to do it is just control click, and there you go. So speaking of this keyframe assistant, another cool trick. Okay, so you have these keyframes. If you hit control C to copy and control V to paste, right click on these keyframes, keyframe assistant, and time reverse. And what that does is it copies your exact keyframes and it reverses them, including all easing. And say, for example, you're in the graph editor and say you've affected these keyframes. So just that right there. So what we'll do, if you copy these, now see our second keyframe right here, it's got this movement on it. If you copy these, control C, control V, right click, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes, you can see in the graph editor, it's copied this exactly, but just put it in reverse. So you have the same exact movement, but backwards. Shortcuts are so important to designers because they save a ton of time. Most designers pick up shortcuts along the way, so you may be familiar with some of these. I will go through a number of other shortcuts next week, so be sure to check that out. I hope this helped you out. Please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything you'd like to see and if this episode was helpful. I'm uploading 3 shape layer images, transitions, or expressions that you can add to your own personal library, so be sure to check out the Dropbox link below. Thanks, everybody. See you next time.